Shalom, this is Frank Buchwald, and I'd like to talk with you about something that's on everybody's mind, Ebola. And the question is, to what extent do medical people or even just volunteers need to help people who are suffering from Ebola and perhaps even risk their own lives? Well, Judaism has a very unique law that's really unique to Judaism, and that is the statement in the Bible that says that you are not permitted to stand by idly while another person might die. So if you have an opportunity to save a person who's drowning, or you have an opportunity to unloose the chains that are holding a child who's tied to a railroad track, then you're required to do that. You're not allowed to stand by idly. So this might have impact on the question of how much we have to volunteer. But the question is the question of risk. How much risk is involved? Well, if you know how to swim and you're a certified lifesaver, then you should jump into the water to save that person. But if you're not, then perhaps you shouldn't, because the risk is too great. Are you allowed to donate a kidney to a person who is so sick that the person will die? Again, the question of risk. And some rabbis would say that if the risk is more than 10%, then you're not required. But if you want, you can go beyond the call of duty. And that's really what we're facing now with the question of Ebola, that a person may take these risks and may subject themselves to the disease. But the question is, what about on the way back, contaminating others and subjecting others to this disease? So now we have the issue of isolation. My own feeling is that these heroic medical people who go to these foreign countries to treat the people with Ebola should see that part of the heroism is also isolating themselves on their way home when they get back. And they should not see it as a burden, but they should see it as part of the treatment of people with Ebola. Besides, who wouldn't want a 21-day vacation? Some people, there's a woman in my office who says, you know, where do I sign up? And I guess that's part of the whole issue of treating Ebola and dealing with taking the risk to help and save another person's life.